There's water in the data center. Like, don't get electrocuted.
Data centers. Why are they so often in the basement? They are arguably the most important part of your infrastructure. But how much do you actually know about the part of the building that your data center is in? Is there some kind of plumbing running through the walls? Are there water pipes overhead? And if something goes wrong down there, do you have any way of knowing? This is the story of a sysadmin named Wayne who ended up with a flooded data center at a well-known US university.
My name is Wayne Tolliver, and I was the IT systems manager.
At the university, part of Wayne's responsibility was a data center located on a separate campus to the main university.
Our building, I have to tell you the story, actually used to be an old car dealership. So it was converted into offices then. And so where all of my servers and storage and networking gear were in this little closet. And then above it was a janitor closet on the second floor. So I had exposed pipes in my room.
The janitor's closet above the data center? Exposed water pipes. Doesn't sound like a good place for a data center. But this is exactly the thing with many data centers. They're often located in out-of-the-way places. A big reason for this is obviously saving on costs. In Wayne's case, keeping the data center separate to the main campus meant reduced costs for floor space every month. And so they decided to convert a small basement room into their data center. Despite the advantages, an out-of-the-way data center means limited visibility of what's actually happening in the room, especially if there's no monitoring in place, as was the case for Wayne's data center.
So we were running completely blind. So the way we would find out about problems is if someone happened to walk by that room and notice something that was going on, or obviously someone calls you, they pick up the phone because something is not working.
And this lack of visibility meant that when a crisis hit, Wayne had to hear about it from a colleague.
And then I heard someone run down the hallway, and then they said, they just blurted it out, "Wayne, there's water in the data center, did you know?" And I'm like, "No, I did not." So
Wayne stopped what he was doing and ran down to the data center, where he was greeted by a disastrous scene. A small river of water running underneath the door. Inside the room, water was leaking from the pipes and ceiling above.
The water was coming down in a flow, and it was running across the top of my APC rack and then down the sides of it. So my rack, the roof of my rack actually protected me a little bit and protected the equipment, the fact that the equipment was enclosed in a rack.
When Wayne saw the scene, he reacted as any sysadmin would have. He stayed calm.
So I was running up and down the hallway, screaming, "Log off, save your work." People were like, "What's going on?" And I said, "There's water in the data center." And then people were like, "Don't get electrocuted."
And while "don't get electrocuted" is great advice for just about any life situation, it is especially good advice in a data center filled with water. In Wayne's situation, he weighed up the danger in the room and decided it was safe enough to go in and access a terminal where he could log off and shut down the various systems. However, we don't necessarily recommend doing the same if you're ever faced with this situation. After the systems were shut down and building facilities had shut the water off upstairs, Wayne and his team started the cleanup.
So after we got everything shut down in the data center, then the folks from the main data center came over from facilities to help us out. We basically made sure the water was shut off. We placed a tarp over the server to keep it from any more water from hitting it from the server rack and the storage. And then what we did is we just got out the shop vac, started vacuuming up the water, mopping up the water, and then just really stabilizing the situation. Then we put some fans in there and made sure things started to dry out.
Looking back on the whole incident, it's clear to Wayne that he had a lot of luck on the day.
So things could have been a whole lot worse. You know, if I start from the top, it wasn't a huge amount of water. It was enough to be concerned. It was obviously enough to cover the floor. It didn't damage any equipment. We did not lose any data. I was not electrocuted. No one got hurt. So we were pretty lucky. But I think the biggest part of luck actually is that someone walked by that room when the water was coming under and they caught it so early. So the timing was critical. That was really, I consider the biggest piece of luck, because the rest of it was just managed carefully. And then that's how we avoided any further loss of data, you know, any injury or so on and so forth.
And just like any crisis situation, Wayne learned a lot from this whole incident.
So I learned three lessons in this experience, and there were several key takeaways. One, we weren't monitoring our data center. And while we had a little bit of luck that helped us out, that might not have been available to us a second time or to someone else in a similar situation. The other thing that I learned was placement of the of your server room, your data center facilities is very key. And you have to think about your surroundings, where you're located, what's above you, what's below you. If you're on the ground level, are you at risk for flooding? If you have someone above you, is there a water source above you? Are you at risk of flooding coming from top down? So that's very important to keep in mind. And then the third lesson that I realized is having an effective disaster recovery plan in place is also very helpful. So I just reacted instinctively and knew to get things shut down, to protect the equipment, to protect the data. And so that ended up being the right course of action. And you always do need to react instinctively, but still a disaster recovery plan being in place also takes into account business continuity and some of these issues. And then had a business continuity disaster recovery plan in place, probably we wouldn't have even been in that facility. We would have been in another facility, realizing how valuable the importance of the data was to the university.
But what exactly does Wayne mean when he talks about monitoring his data center?
So today, if I were to set up a server room, again, that's not part of a tier one or tier two data center, I would make sure that environmental monitoring is a key component of that, which ties into a network monitoring platform like PRTG. So for example, there are components available from APC. Their product line is NetBots, and they have flood detection sensors, they have smoke detection sensors, and they have humidity sensors. So deploying those sensors at key points in the room, close to water sources, underneath the rack, behind the rack, in front of the rack, even on top of the rack, can help you detect leaks as soon as possible and get in front of them. So having an environmental equipment and having it tied in with monitoring, so then you get alerted and notified when those events happen. So my call to action is, if you have a server room out there and you don't have environmental monitoring that's tied in with your network monitoring, get on top of it.
And that's Wayne's story. To find out about data center monitoring with PRTG, check out the links in the description. And if you have a sysadmin story you want to tell, write us a comment and maybe we'll feature you on our YouTube channel.